All right, in this file, we're working in Illustrator, and it is showing you some examples of how to use grids in your work. All right, so we're doing a new file. I have it set to 8 by 8 inches, and we will just call this grid example. Create. All right, so first thing is rulers. You can turn them on by clicking Command-R on your Mac. Turn them off with Command-R. You can see they turn on at the top and on the side. You can also do that by rulers, hide rulers. You can see the key command here. Hide, view, rulers, show rulers. So this is similar to Photoshop. You can click in your ruler and drag a guide. Click and drag a guide. The preferences for what guides look like is Illustrator Preferences Guides. All right, so for guides, I always like them cyan. And I don't like them as dots, I like them as lines. For your grid, I also like to see maybe light gray as a grid, and I always want to see lines. So this preference can be different for everyone, but you would go into preferences, guides, and grids to set your styles. Say okay. So this is what much more what I'm used to. So I have my black selection tool, the arrow, selected, and I can't move the guides. This is because you have an option under guides that you can lock and unlock. So if I unlock the guides, now I can move them around to where I want. If I have them where I want and I am ready to start designing and I don't want to accidentally move them, then that would be a good time to come in and lock guides again. You can also clear your guides. So if you're done with them or they're not in the right place, you can say clear guides. So by default, your rulers are going to align with the edge of your artboard. If you were to draw a new artboard and you focus on that artboard, the zero aligns again. So that's the default behavior. There are different settings, but that's a pretty useful one. So each time you change to a different artboard, your rulers will change there. Now you can drag from the corner and decide that you want to set your zero anywhere you want. So you can see now I've set it there. And now I can bring it back. So it's those little dotted lines that I'm pulling. All right, so if we want a full grid, we can go to Show Grid. And you can see it actually already has a grid built for me. I can come into Preferences, Guides and Grids. This is where you can see what the colors are of your grid. Also, how you're dividing. So if you wanted to make it 1 inch and maybe we're just breaking it into 1/4 inches inside. So now these are 1 inch grids with 1/4 inch inside each one. So you can change your settings, and again, that's view, hide grid, or show grid. Those are the basics of creating your grid in Illustrator.